Hello my friends, Rune here again from Oslo, Norway. And in today's video, I want to try out my black Walther PPQ M2 42 caliber paintball pistol with the aluminium or aluminum balls that my good friend Daniel Spencer sent me. He wanted me to try it in my black slided version, and he also wanted me to try shooting at harder tin cans. This one is extremely solid. I don't think even my HDR50 will make a hole in it, but it's solid, extremely solid. And I also have a softer tin can here. This one, I guess it will make a hole in, but I'm not so sure about the other one. But since Daniel asked if I could try it, at least I'll try one shot. And I guess it will bounce around the ricochet, so I guess only one shot, but we will see. So I also have the quick access balls. They weigh, what is it, 0.88 gram or something. And I also have a few other balls, I think. Yes, I have the wrap 4 24 grain balls, and I have a few of the power balls. They are 20.8 grain, if I remember correctly. So let's see. I'm using my own 6mm hex wrench Allen key, because I have shitty arthritic fingers, and I think I will put in some silicone spray, and as always, a Umarex brand CO2 canister. I find this quite clean compared to others. That's why I use them. They're also not that expensive. So, but I will load up aluminium balls first, pulling down the magazine follower and lock it in place. And then we just feed the balls in from the top. Just show you with one here, pulling down the magazine follower, and then just drop the balls in from the top. The magazine holds 8 balls. So let me load up the remaining balls, and then we can try some shots and see if my chrono can give us some chrono numbers, and if it will make a hole or at least a dent in some of the tin cans. One moment. Okay. I put up the hard tin can there. It's from Thailand. It's what they call koke. It means peanuts, roasted peanuts in some sort of coconut flavor. Very good, by the way. But the tin can is very hard. Now load it up with the aluminium ball. Let's see. Sort of chrono number it will give, and if it will ricochet. I hope not, but let's see. It certainly ricocheted. 298, and as I suspected, only a dent. It will not make a hole in more solid tin can. So let me put up this tin can. Here's the ball. You roll it down on the floor. So first shot, 298. 287. And it made a hole there. And it also cracked the rear of the can. And here's the ball. So, let me try. See if I can do it the gangster way. Because of my stiff, shitty fingers. Dropping even more. 274. That was the first shot. That was the second shot. And not sure if it made a... Yes, it made a dent there. .286. Here's the ball. And it made a hole there. .284, very stable velocity. And again, ripped a hole there. Let me turn it a bit more sideways. Maybe we can manage to cut the tin can in half. It says F. That means low battery, so I need to change the battery. But that was the last shot. So let me change the battery and do a little reload. Load it up again and have some shots so we can see the impact in the tin can there. Aluminium balls again. So, let's see. .289. And the lid fell off. And it only dented the can. Okay. Let's try again. .289 again. As you can see, it's not a powerhouse. It will shoot hole in a softer tin can. So let's see if we can make some shots below the other ones there. .277. And I made a hole, of course. .269. This time it only dented. There's the ball. And I only made a dent there. So, there is a reason these pistols are not under any sort of license. You can buy them simply by being 18 years old. .271. This time it made a hole. 269, and here's the ball, and only a dent there. Try again. 261, starting to drop, and it made a hole there, but I can't see the ball. It's not inside. There it is. And heating these hard objects really takes a toll on the aluminium balls. It has a huge dent there. So let's try again. Then I will switch to the other ammo, but then I will not shoot at the can or anything, because that will ruin them for sure. 262. Ball is inside, and I think it was about here. And I think I also need a reload. One moment.
And now, load it up with the quick access balls from Umarex. 0.88 gram, I think it was. Not shooting at anything specific. Just into my trap there. Getting some chrono numbers. .345, .347, .349, .333. 330, 328, 322, 326. 5-0. And now load it up with the Rep 4 and the Umarex power balls. The Rep 4 is 24 grains, and the power balls is 20.8 grains. So first two shots with the power balls. 20.8 grain, 294, 291, 294, and now it's the 24 grain, 277. 275, 271, 264, 264, 256, and we're out of ammo.
So, as you could see, the more solid the tin cans, it will only dent, no holes. But the softer tin cans, it will shoot a hole through or in, at least one side. So almost cut it in half. So yes, I could always have shot a few more shots before it was out of CO2, but I see no point in just standing there, and it's getting slower and slower and slower. So but it's a fun pistol for what it is. I'm shooting with powder balls. It makes a nice puff when hitting hard objects. I've done some in earlier videos. So yeah, very fun to click with. This one I have shot a bit with, and the trigger pull is much better than on my new blue slided version. So, but if you want to buy the pistol, you can buy it here in Norway from Game On. And if you're using the coupon code RUNEREBELL, you will get a 13% discount. Yes. But that's it for today. I hope you like my little testing shooting video. See you in another time, and thank you for watching.